Hello students, today we will discuss uniform and non-uniform motion. Let us start uniform and non-uniform motion. I am taking an example. Suppose a body starts moving from point O and reaches to point A in 1 second by covering distance 100 meter, and at 2 second it reaches to point B and its position from the origin becomes 200 meter. At 3 second it reaches to point C and this distance is 300 meter. And so on. Now what you are seeing? You are seeing that in 1 second, in each second, the body is covering 100 meter distance. This is 200 meter, therefore 200 minus 100, that will be 100 meter. This is 100 meter. This is 100 meter. This is 100 meter. So what we are seeing? We are seeing that in each second, the body is covering 100 meter distance. This type of motion is called uniform motion. So what will be the definition of uniform motion? When a moving body covers equal displacement in equal time interval, then such motion is called uniform motion. Or you can define, when a body covers equal distances in equal time interval in a straight line, then that motion is called uniform motion. Now come to non-uniform motion. I am taking the same example, but here I am supposing this distance is 100 meter, this is 250 meter, and this one is 500 meter. Now in this case, what you are saying? This distance is 100 meter, therefore this distance will be 250 minus 100, so this will be 150 meter. And this is 250, this is 500, therefore this will be 250 meter. So what you are seeing? Finally, you are seeing that in 1 second, in first second, it is covering 100 meter distance. In another second, it is covering 150 meter. In next second, it is covering 250 meter. So in this case, unequal displacements are covered by the body in equal time interval. That's why this type of motion is called non-uniform motion. Means we can define non-uniform motion as when a body covers unequal displacements or unequal distances in equal time interval, or equal distances in unequal time interval, then that motion is called non-uniform motion. Actually, in non-uniform motion, either the speed of the body changes, speed or direction of the body changes, or both speed and direction of the body changes. In all the cases, the motion is non-uniform motion. So, we have discussed uniform motion and non-uniform motion. What kind of motion you will say uniform, and what type of motion you will say non-uniform motion. Now, we are discussing about the speed. All of you are aware with the speed. Actually, the ratio of distance traveled to the time taken is called time taken is called is speed. It's very simple. The ratio of distance traveled by the body to the time taken by the body is called speed. Means speed is equal to distance upon time, meter per second. Its unit is meter per second. Speed is equal to distance upon time. Its dimension formula will be LT minus 1. Its dimension formula will be LT minus 1. Now come to average speed. आप सभी इस बात को तो जान ही रहे हैं कि एवरेज कब निकालते हैं। हमें पता है जब कोई क्वांटिटी चेंज होती है, जब कोई फिजिकल क्वांटिटी चेंज होगी तभी हम एवरेज निकालते हैं, क्योंकि अगर वो चेंज नहीं हो रही है तो एवरेज वैल्यू भी वही होगी जो कि स्पीड की होगी। यहां पे हमने यूनिफॉर्म मोशन लिया हुआ था, बॉडी इक्वल डिस्टेंस इक्वल टाइम इंटरवल में कवर कर रही थी, लेकिन यहां पे हमने नॉन यूनिफॉर्म अगर अनइक्वल डिस्टेंसेस इक्वल टाइम इंटरवल में कवर कर रही है तो वहां पे हमको एवरेज स्पीड फाइंड करना होगा। एक्चुअली एवरेज स्पीड क्या होता है? एवरेज स्पीड इज द रेशियो ऑफ टोटल डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल्ड बाय द बॉडी टू द टाइम टेकन बाय द बॉडी। एवरेज स्पीड इज इक्वल टू टोटल डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल्ड टू द टोटल टाइम टेकन अपॉन टोटल टाइम। टोटल डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल टू द टोटल टाइम टेकन। सो लेट अस डिस्कस सम केसेस इन विच वी हैव टू फाइंड एवरेज स्पीड। I am supposing a body starts moving from point A and covers distance S1 in time T1. S1 in time T1. Time T1 is taken by the body to cover distance S1. Point C, and this distance is S2. Time taken by the body is T2. Point B, this distance is S3 and time is T3. Time taken. These are the time intervals, not absolute time. From this point to this point, the body takes time T1. From this point to this point, not from this to this. From point B to C, the body covers distance S2 and takes time T2. From this to this, that is in S3 distance, the body takes time T3. So what will be the value of average speed? You know, total distance. So S1 plus S2 plus S3 upon total time. It is very simple. You can use the formula and average speed can be calculated. Now, let us discuss another case. Case number 2. Suppose during the covering of distance S1, the body moves with the speed V1. In traveling distance S2, the body is moving with the speed V2, and in S3 its speed becomes V3. Now what will be the average speed? The formula will be same, but you are not knowing the exact time. T1, T2, T3 are not given, so you have to find what time it will take for covering distance S1. So time is equal to distance upon speed, S1 upon V1. This is S1 plus S2 plus S3. So time T1 will be S1 upon V1, T2 will be S2 upon V2, and T3 will be S3 upon, these are the times T1, T2 and T3. This is the average speed. This is the average. Now come to the third case. I'm supposing distances are not given. Means body travels with speed v1 for time t1, with speed v2 for time t2, with speed v3 for time t3. Means I'm supposing the body covers distance AB with speed v1, BC with speed v2, and CD with speed v3. Again, we will use the same formula. Formula doesn't change, only the terms which are given, you have to place them in this formula. So S1 is not given. So in place of S1, distance is equal to speed multiplied by time, v1 t1. In place of S2, it will be v2 t2. In place of S3, it will be v3 t3 upon times of t1 plus t2 plus t3. This will be the formula. So you can use the formula 1, 2 and 3 according to your need, according to the numerical problem. Now I am discussing two numerical problems which are very simple. First, a body covers half journey or distance with speed v1 and rest half with speed v2, with speed v2, find the average speed. Find the average speed. You can use the same formula. The body covers half distance. Suppose the journey is AB and its midpoint is this. So if the total distance is 2 S, then this distance will be what? S. And this distance will be S. Now see the question. A body covers half distance, means this distance, with speed V1. With speed V1. And rest half distance with speed v2, means in this distance the body is traveling with speed v2. Find the average speed. What will be the average speed? Total distance, you know, s1 plus s2 means s plus s. You can take the total distance s, then this will be s by 2. And I have taken 2s distance for your convenience, so that its calculation will be very easy. S plus S, and time is equal to, you know, distance upon speed. So finally, what you can write? This is 2S. Take S common, 1 upon V1 plus 1 upon V2. S will be cancelled with S, and you may write 1 upon V1 plus 1 upon V2. After solving, you can write 2V1 V2 upon V1 plus V2. This is the average speed. It is very simple. Now I am changing the question. A body, second question is, a body travels half distance half time with speed v1 and rest half time half time with speed V2. Find the average speed. Average speed.
You have to find the average speed. So again, you have to use the same formula. What is the formula? Total distance upon total time. S1 plus S2 upon total time is T1 plus T2. You can see, I am assuming the journey from A to B. And the total time is 2T. So half time will be T. In half time, the body moves with speed what? V1. And in another half time, it moves with speed V2. I am supposing in time T, the body is covering distance this S1. S1 is equal to distance is equal to speed multiplied by time. And in rest half time, second distance will be V2 into T. So what will be the average speed? You know, average speed is equal to total distance upon total time. So S1 plus S2 means V1. This is T1. T1 means T. V1T plus V2T upon T plus T. That will be what? T will be cancelled with T. And you are left with V1 plus V2 upon. So this is the average speed in this case. If the body travels half time with the speed V1 and rest half time with the speed V2, its average speed will be V1 plus V2 upon. So this is all about average speed and based numericals. Thanks.